Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Rekha, a self-taught artist living in Sweden. I paint both watercolors as well as acrylics. In today's illustration, we are going through a painting process of a stone chariot for which I have used acrylics. Hope you will enjoy this painting, and please do leave your comments or feedbacks in the comment section. Please do subscribe. Thank you. Let's see the colors I have used in this painting. It's a primary yellow, cyan, magenta, red ochre, orange yellow, permanent green, ultramarine, and titanium white. I am using primary cyan and ultramarine blue in combination with titanium white. I'm mostly keeping the sky clear to represent the bright sunny day. I'm covering this white area in thin layers of paints. At the end of this painting, I don't want any white canvas to peek through the final painting. Once we are done with covering all this structure in thin layers of paint, we are jumping onto this underpainting section. Underpainting is a process of defining values of a structure. In our case, it is in this stone chariot, we have deeper shadows. As we are going to, the mood of this painting is going to be a bright sunny day. So we have to pay attention to this shadow part. So there are I'm starting with defining this darker tones of shadows as well as lighter tones of shadows. For this shadow coloring, I have used red ochre in combination with primary cyan. You can also use burnt umber directly from the tube for this. So initially I have not mixed any water with this or any other media, thinning media. So I have just directly painted it. And for the second level or second value of this shadow or underpainting, I have used water in the same color mixture and applied to the second level of shadows. Most of the times it is done directly on the white canvas, but I always prefer to work like this. So it's up to you how you would like to do it. As soon as you start working on the entire structure, you will get an idea how it would look or how your shadows are looking, and they play a lot important role in any painting. You can see the outcome of this underpainting process. In the third layer, the objective of this painting is to achieve more definitive structures. I have used all colors directly from the tube, and the fun part is to mix them on canvas directly instead of on palette. For me, the intention is to keep the vibrancy of the colors intact. I feel maybe mixing on the palette sometimes destroys the pigments. So I'm paying a lot of attention to keep the dark values I have already painted in the second layer, and I'm trying to retain those dark values and painting alongside to reflect the actual color of the chariot. I am using greens and blues and mixed with the red ochre to define the shadows. For warmer shadows which are facing the direct sunlight, I'm using green in combination with red ochre just to bring that warmness in the shadow. And to reflect the light on the structure, I have used orange yellow and primary yellow along with titanium white and some of red ochre tints here and there. And the objective here, as I said, to define more definitive structures. As you can see, I am trying to push some things back. In the upper part of the chariot, we mostly are seeing the shadows. So I am using cyan and magenta along with the red ochre to define more and more shadows, which at the end brings life to the chariot. As this structure is a bit complicated, I am moving section by section in this third layer, but the idea is to cover the entire area and the stone chariot along with some more structures behind the chariot in this third layer. In this chariot, there are many figuratives which are carved as I come down to the stone chariot structure. I mean, the section, more and more light will hit onto this chariot. So, I am trying to reflect that light using yellows and whites, as I said earlier. Basically, it is the art of developing this painting layer by layer. So I have planned to complete this painting in four layers. So now we are into third layer. Here I am just defining the structures, shadows, lights, creating more into the structure. Just observe the process of this painting. I am more concentrating on the shadows and lights of each area of this chariot. Thank you. for the backside of this temple, I am going with more cooler colors. I don't want that to stand out in this painting, because the main focal point or focal attraction in this painting is the stone chariot, which is at the front. So at the same time, I don't want to give less details to that backside temple. You still have to define more definitions or structures in that temple, but with cool colors. I am neutralizing this warm red ochre with blue as well as magenta and white to form a cooler color. So let's cover the entire painting with the third layer. Now we have finished the third layer for the entire painting. I am starting with the fine details in the chariot, which I call it as fourth layer. This is going to be the final layer, which has the tiny details into the stone chariot structure. I am paying more attention on this wheel structure as well as the elephant of the chariot, creating some interesting patterns of light and the flower design and the shadows into the wheels. While painting this fine structure, what I am painting right now, you have to pay attention to the direction of the sunlight, because this is basically a shadow what I am painting right now, and later on I will go on adding some light colors which represents the sunlit sides of the wheel. So everywhere it won't be the same angle. Thank you. hope you all enjoyed this painting process. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel Clash of Colors. Thank you.